Hallelujah! The God Phoenix from Gatchaman Battle of the Planets is finally in from the folks at MRC Model Rectifier Corporation. They're distributing this in the United States. They sent me a copy so I could show you. Remember when I built the new God Phoenix, the white and red ship? Well, this is the original one from the cartoon with the accessory vehicles, the cool little peoples with all their wings and all that. So a lot of people knew it as Battle of the Planets. Other people knew it as Gatchaman, depending on what kind of cartoon you were into, whether you watched it from Japan or you watched it in the United States version. So this is supposed to be a pressed together kit, pre-colored, ready for you, shouldn't need any paint at all. And this one, the one distributed by MRC in the United States, will have the LED light kit included. Big sticker right there, LED module included. So let's take a look at all the cool parts that are in the box. We've got a set of press-on stickers. If you just want to push the kit together and slap on some decals, this is your option to do so. Gives you enough to give you detail on the vehicle, or you can use a combination or only the waterslide decal sheet, which has as many decals on it. I mean, look at those. Each individual little decal on there. I'm not going to be using all of those, but we'll use a lot of them from here. I'll be building mine up with the water slides. You can see all the detail on there. These are little white hash surrounds for different panels. Probably see them better on the sticker sheet there, right there. That's what they look like. So we've got a nice water slide sheet. We've got all the LED components. All the LED lights, the switch, the battery connectors, you get to build it all and the manual will walk you through it easily. We got some nice adhesive clear tape. What that does is hold the wires and different things in place inside the hull for you. We've got a spring and a screw to activate the switch. That we get to put together. We've got an awesome clear parts tree with optional flame effects. I'm going to link to the new God Phoenix review, and you'll see how they look on that one and how that one went together. And now this one with all the cool flame effects, the warning switch cover, the engine outlets, the flames coming out of the engine, the little afterburner marks. Check out those little flame marks coming out of there. So this will be fun. This is the one that a lot more people recognize, and they came out with it kind of second. Now we've got multicolored trees of sprue. We've got this nice gunmetal metallic sprue. Nice vents on there. Check out the molding detail in those. All the way around the engines, the collars. Awesome parts. I don't think I'm going to have to put any paint on this at all. Got all the red parts. Look at the nose cone, how sharp they get that. That's modern molding and design. Got the big red, I know that from the other kit, the switch. When you flip that clear orange warning, you press that and our LED lights will come on. Awesome detail on there. You can kind of see the size of the kit. That's the nose cone right there. And that is right there on this big jet. We've got some dark gray, not black, but very dark gray accent parts. Engine pieces. Check out that intake. Pretty friggin' sweet. Looks like impossible landing gear parts. Main hull parts. You can always tell with those like hexagon holes how things will press together. When I did the new God Phoenix, I have hopes for this one because everything on that fits without issue. Here we've got the large base with our battery door. Our large base where that orange and the red switch will go and the orange cover. This is the base that the model will sit on. Got all of our landing gear done up in charcoal. Got some nice fans. Battery door. Yeah, I like, we get a little electronics going on. We get all some plastic. Here's all the base for the model. This is what it will sit on. So you can tell the size. Here's the accessory vehicles. Some of the landing gear for the main vehicle. Accessory vehicles, we got missiles, little mini jets with wings going on there. Got that little shark fin back there. Such nice detail. Another little vehicle there. I don't know if I'll paint up the little stuff. but we'll get it assembled. We'll get it assembled so it works with the kit. Here's part of the main fuselage. Really sharp looking. Maybe I can work some panel line wash in there. We'll see what I can do. They are very nicely done. Nicely accented. We got the wings here. You can see the panel line work in there. In person, on screen, they don't show up real well. In person, they're very clear. That's why I was debating panel line wash or just leaving them. Other different fuselage parts. Beautiful blue plastic. Looks just like the box art. It's not a lighter tone or too dark. Here's this huge, I'm assuming is the back. Love how that looks like a bird with that design, hence the Phoenix name. Must be some pretty intricate slide molding going on there. Get that work done. And the plastic color is consistent. I don't see a lot of swirls. Here's what looks like the top of the fuselage to me. Outstanding. Hoses and lines. If you want to paint it up, detail it more. I think just the decals and everything will go fine. There we got some more nose cone detail. So that's all the awesome sauce in that box. There's a lot of stuff in there. It shows you the functionality of the model on the box. That's what it's going to look like on the base. Check out that flame detail that you get to light up with the LEDs. You got that big windshield in the clear plastic. There's the base with that orange cover and the red switch and the model sitting on it. There's not a drop of paint on that. That's just built out of the box, and that's what I think I'm going to do. I'll be right back as I start to build. with that work, it's a couple hours pushing it all together, cutting the parts and everything like that. You got a couple hours invested into that, and I showed you how pretty much the entire assembly goes, except for some of the minor stuff like pushing this stuff in and snapping it on and all that stuff. We got the LED lights set in. We got the batteries in the base. We are all set to go. All I have to do now is apply the decals. I'm going to be using the water slide. Now, I'm not going to be using the billion little call-outs on the panel lines. If you want to do that, you go right ahead. But those are so teeny. I will be using all the different panel outlines. There's dozens of them here. All the different logos, circular outlines, the red decals, the Gatchaman logos, the Phoenix 5, the Danger intake logos, those kind of things I'll be using because those look wonderful. We want to get those on the kit. The book, if you decide to, you can go ahead and paint all those mini vehicles exactly as they are in the cartoon, full color guide, and they dedicate 3 pages to exactly where to place all the water slides. So you are all set. They give you full color views of the ship. If you wanted to do any custom painting or decorating, they give you where the decals go on the small ships and all of that. So that is absolutely fantastic that they include it. This is how it sits out of the box as is. And it has options. It's a multiple in one kit. Underneath, let's take, well, maybe it'll stay on. Some of this stuff, because of playability, will fall off. It's not super tight. You see how I've got the engine here with the vents open on the bottom? You've got the other engine that goes here, of course, if you're going to attach it to the base and use the lights and all that and have it displayed, that you will omit those parts. Those parts are here for the fans that you won't put in. And as I've got it displayed open, or you can close them off. So you've got those options in the kit to do so. You've got, like I showed, the landing gear, which comes in and out. I want it in flight mode, so I've got everything sealed up as it is. That's why I'm showing you all the options available on the kit. We've got the larger wings for the ship that comes out of the tail here that slides out, and it's its own little airplane. You can switch and swatch because of the pressability of the kit, the press fit. You can switch and swatch those wings together. We've got the little guy that sits on the nose. I showed him in the other part of the building. We've got the vehicles that come out of the wingtips. They hang below on each side like that. They just hang on the sides. We have those in there. We've got our 2 lower missiles. And we also showed it during the building where this is all smooth now. You can switch and swap it out with these 3 missiles and the other panel line cover. You can also add and remove the God Phoenix flames. Those things are awesome. Take that nose off like I showed in the build video and you're all set. And then underneath this little warning hatch is the switch to turn the lights on and off. So we've got the lights on. It looks really cool with the flames coming out the back. Let me shut off the shop lighting. You can see we got the dome light out the top. We got the flames coming out the back. And then we've got the engines on the sides all glowing up, firing away. And that's all easy to wire. You can go ahead and solder those if you want, but wrapping the tape around them is just fine. We're only dealing with 4.5 volts DC here. You're not going to electrocute anyone or start a fire as long as you keep them from shorting out. As long as you use that tape that they give you plenty of to seal those wires, you're not going to have a problem. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to apply my decals. I'm going to get those on the model, and then I'm going to give everything a flat coat, except for, of course, the cool flame features. And then we will come back for that final reveal on the turntable. And I'll bring down the new God Phoenix, its companion ship. Also, if you wanted to see how the wings work on this one, because you can do the drop wings. The other one, the new God Phoenix, were a clacker style to move them around. This one, you pop the wing out and let it drop. Pop it out and let it drop. And then you've got that really cool-looking droop wing Klingon-style thing kind of going on there. And when you want them to sit straight, you lift them up, push them in, lift them up, push them in, and that is designed perfectly by Academy. You can see they don't droop when you push them in. You don't see any gaps or anything like that. It looks wonderful. So I will be right back with the final reveal with the new God Phoenix next to it. And with applications of the decals, the water slide ones are the ones that I used because there were much more on the sheet. Then I gave it all a spray coat of flat clear. Whatever brand you choose, I just use an acrylic flat clear. Dulls it down and helps blend in those decals. About the decals, do they apply easily? Super yes. They are cartograph decals. They are very, very thin. The color register is very strong. There's no bleed through. They went on nicely. Something that happened with this kit that's only happened with one other Academy kit, and that had cartograph decals too. Usually, cartograph decals are some of the best in the business and you can't beat them. Well, for some reason, when I apply all my decals to speed up my process, I put my model into a food dehydrator. It is a home-style food dehydrator. We're not going to go into what type it is. I put them in there for 90 degrees at about 30 minutes. So 90 degrees, not hot at all, just warm, dry air over the model for 30 minutes gets all my decals to lay down flat and beautifully, which it did on this one, except for a few of the decals. The big G's for the Gatchaman logos and the little circle emblems, the panel line indicators around these side vents on either side, they shriveled up and disappeared. The Gatchaman logos stayed on, but they shriveled up. The round ones just blew away completely and shriveled into nothing like a shrinky dink and disappeared. I don't know why. Obviously, when you build yours, don't use the food dehydrator method at 90 degrees to dry them up. Don't use it at 80, don't use it at 100. Just let them dry naturally and everything would have been fine. So that's my mistake, not the model. I trust cartograph decals in everything. And I know it's not the decals problem. Something about that 90 degrees in that dehydrator on today's day made the little circles dry up and fly away and made the Gatchaman logos, just the Gatchaman logos, shrivel up on the edges. So I coated it with my clear after a little incident to make sure none of the other ones dried up and blew away. And then we are all set. It's a beautiful model. Goes together awesome. Assembles, the decals are gorgeous. They really enhance the look of the model once you get the decals on. We've got the new God Phoenix in the back from the last build. You can see the differences in the ship. Both of these kits are available right now. Both of them assemble easily. Didn't have any issues with the decals on the new God Phoenix. That's how we know it's just a luck of the draw thing. And just to be more safe than sorry, I wouldn't worry about your cartograph decals on your Gatchaman model. Just don't try to warm up the air around them to get them to conform. They lay down nicely as it is. They suck into the panel lines all on their own. So just some mild decal solvent if you want to use it. Let them dry. Then go ahead, give your clear coat to knock down the glossiness of the decals so that the whole ship matches up. I removed the orange cockpit and the bubble because they are a press fit before I clear coated it with flat. And I never bothered doing the Phoenix logo within flames or the flames coming out of the back, because why would you? So I left those nice and gloss. The kit looks amazing. The lights are on it right now. We'll shut down the bright shop lighting and let you see all lit up. Rockets coming out of the back. We got our dome in the front, and the front part, of course, doesn't light up at all, but that's how it looks with the lights on. Looks pretty cool in any room that it'll be in. And the new God Phoenix does the same. I mean, it's cool to have, now that I have both of these, for any anime or manga fan. Yeah, now I've got them both. I've got the collection, I've got the original, which was extremely anticipated, and I've got the new version. I think they're so cool. I thank MRC for sending this over. These build up so nice, they're so well done. Let me again show you how to make the wings drop. You just pull them out and let them fall. And that's how you make the wings drop on the new God Phoenix, on the old God Phoenix. On the new one, they ratchet into place because they have multiple movements. So awesome looking kits. They are true to the cartoon. You got the missiles out of the top. You drop the little guys out. You got the rear hatch that pulls off. It is just wonderful. These are both in stock at MRC, or you can get your favorite hobby shop to order them for you. Link will be down in the description. Remember, build the models that you like because they're your models and your hobby. Have fun doing it. Smile. Remember, it's just a hobby and we're here for a good time. I'll see all of you at the next review.